Sue and I are once again excited to bring you another group of hymns in our holiday version of Hymnology. I personally love all the carols of Advent and Christmas. We hope that you enjoy learning the history of many of these beloved holiday carols, as well as the singing of the carols too. Thank you so much for listening, and we hope this is a wonderful way to get yourself into the spirit of the Advent Christmas season.
Charles Wesley was the youngest son and 18th child of Samuel and Susanna Wesley. Born in December of 1707, he is considered the great hymn writer of the Wesley family. He wrote the word to thousands of hymns in his lifetime. For countless Christians around the world, this hymn signals the beginning of Advent. With music composed by Roland Pritchard, it was first published in 1745 in Charles Wesley's edition of Christmas hymns entitled Hymns for the Nativity of Our Lord. This little collection was so popular that it was reprinted 20 times during Wesley's lifetime. It contained 18 Christmas carols Charles had written, of which Come Thou Long Expected Jesus is the most well known. This hymn for the first Sunday in Advent comes from a devastating time in 17th century Europe, known as the 30 Years' War. The struggle between the Protestant prince of Bohemia and the tyranny of the Catholic emperor led to the plundering of the land by troops and untold suffering, bringing on disease and famine. Yet, this is an era that has given to Christianity some of its finest German hymns. Born in 1590, George Weissel was a Prussian scholar, schoolteacher, and pastor. He was also considered one of the most important hymn writers of his time. He wrote some 20 hymns, most of which are based on themes related to the various seasons of the Christian year. Weissel based today's hymn on his reflection on Psalm 24:7, which reads, Lift up your heads, O you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Published in 1642, translated into English in 1855, Lift up your heads, ye mighty gates.
Lift up your heads, ye mighty gates. Behold, the King of glory waits. The King grace and love in us reveal. Thy Holy Spirit lead us on until our glorious goal is won. Eternal praise, eternal fame be offered, Savior, to thy name.
Our last hymn for today takes us back over 1,200 years to life in the monastery. In the 800s, a series of Latin hymns were sung each day during Christmas Vespers from December 17th through the 23rd. Each of these hymns began with the word O and are called antiphons, which means psalm or anthem. These hymns were restructured into verse form in the 1100s and finally published in Latin in 1710. In the mid-1800s, they were discovered by an English minister and scholar named John Mason Neal, who wove together segments of them to produce the first draft of O Come, Emmanuel, which he titled Draw Nigh, Emmanuel. Born in London in 1818, Neal attended Cambridge University and proved to be a brilliant student and prize-winning poet. He composed original hymns, including two volumes of hymns for children. He spent countless hours researching and translating Greek and Latin hymns into English. He claimed no rights to his text and had no issue with editors amending his work. With music provided by Thomas Helmore, published in 1851, O Come, Emmanuel.
Come thou root
Thank you once again for listening. We look forward to bringing you several more weeks of wonderful Christmas carols. Please share these videos with family and friends. We hope you have a terrific week, and we will see you again soon.